library update. The library has officially moved into their new location. It looks pretty cool. They moved in on the 19th of February. They are now on the C floor right at the end of the corridor. This is the place for you if you really love books. It's also a quiet place to sit and read, and there is a monthly book club you should go to it. So far, all your reading, for all your research, for chilling out and enjoying some downtime. Visit your new library now.
Escape. Well, that's every day for an ordinary girl. Meet Bella, an awkward 15-year-old girl who just can't stay normal. Have you ever been awkwardly social? Socially awkward? If so, you should start this fantastic read right away. You can't get this book in the library, but a recommendation will be made.
Digital Detox Challenge. S1 pupils have been taking part in a 7-day digital detox challenge where they have to try refrain from using different parts of their digital devices each day over a week, 1 week period. People have found that this is quite a challenge. Potentially limiting themselves to 3 videos a day and no going online after tea.
This has led to some pupils avoiding having their tea until midnight and downloading 3 feature-length films instead of their usual diet of YouTube fails and memes. So how did you get on? Are you willing to detox yourself for a week?
And senior pupils are at the exciting stage of choosing their subjects for next year. With so many choices from the and important career decisions to be made, see your guidance teacher, subject teacher and Miss Avis, our career advisor, for help and advice. Forms should be returned ASAP, or you may be left with National 4 envelope licking.
Sports update. Rugby has started up again after the winter break. Get along to training on Thursday lunchtime and take part in the annual Perfang and Ross Rugby Sevens tournaments. With competitions coming up soon in football, basketball and hockey, watch this space for success, stories and get along to your friendly neighbourhood PE teacher and Mr. Dudgeon to take part in some great events.
Championships were held on the 12th of February. All races were competitive and the results were as follows. S1 boys champion Jamie Wilson of 1 Arm 1 was Lewis Scott of 1 Arm 2 second. S1 girls champion Leah McLaren of 1 Woman 3 was Ella Rutherford second. S2 boys champion Cameron Wilkes with Dylan Stewart second. S2 girls champ was Ailey Danis and Emma Falconer second. S3 boys winner Lewis Wilson, runner-up Logan Taylor. S3 girls winner Beth Laney, Katie Pastor was second. In S4, Jack Bell was the boys' champion. Well done to all who took part.
Miller Lite. Perth residents have been treated to a spectacular light show on the banks of the Tay, from a Scottish theme to a superheroes theme, and ending with in a romantic Valentine's display. There was something for everyone. If you didn't manage to get along, here are some images of a spectacular light.
LGBT History Month, and today we celebrate Purple Friday, a day to stand up against homophobia, biphobia and transphobia and show our support for LGBTI young people. This year's theme is Everyday Hero. This is simply a person who makes LGBTI friends and strangers feel safe, supported and included. It's about the simple things, not making assumptions about someone's gender or sexuality. Making people feel valued, being respectful and kind. The rainbow flag has been flying all month at the Perth and Kinross Council buildings in the High Street, and here at Perth Grammar School we have our own History Month display. From March 5th, a new club for LGBTI pupils and supporters will meet every Monday lunchtime. If you're interested in coming along, you can ask me for more details or talk to anyone in pupil support and guidance.
Well, I think if we all make the effort, and we shouldn't think of it as an effort, it's a responsibility to make Scotland a welcoming, inclusive place. But if we all do that, then we start from the premise of valuing people as human beings, as valuing them for who they are. And if that's the foundation on which we build our society, then society is going to be a much better place as a result.
I think you're in there for the heroes, but...
Oh, thank you. So right.
Ben's good.
I think it's probably not so much for myself about thinking about the word hero, because I think I would be inclined to agree with Ben. I think it's more about just wanting to try and make sure that you're being a good person and that you're just attempting to be the best person that you can be. And like Ben says, even if you leave after one day and you've helped at least one person feel even remotely better about themselves or the situation, then it's been a good day.
A lot of people find it really difficult to kind of accept that they're a role model, because it's that very British thing of, how can I possibly be a role model and a role model? But I think the nature of what we do, we're not trailblazers, but we do great things and we are people to be looked up to because we're seen, we're visible.
I think in the wedding industry it's very important to create a warm, welcoming atmosphere, because it's a special time in people's lives. Emotions are running high, a lot is riding on it, people spend a lot of money on it, and it's something that needs to be perfect. So regardless of who you are or why you're getting married, it's important to come to a business that supports you and is going to be helpful.
It's been proven time and time again in different organisations. If you have a repeat of the same type of character in your organisation, so the classic term is always, as I said before, male pool style. Everyone comes up with the same ideas, whereas if you have different backgrounds, if you have someone who's a lesbian, if you have someone who's Sikh, you know, different backgrounds, different ways of thinking, then you've far more chance of having an effective team.
The church community is a very broad one. We have people from different backgrounds, different nationalities, different cultures, different denominations, and my job is not to turn them all into good, solid Presbyterians, but it's to allow people to discover their own faith, to walk with God, and to do that without imposing one particular view. And that would be true of whatever nationality they come from, whatever background, or whatever sexuality.
But I think the important thing is modelling your values as a head teacher to the rest of the staff. And making sure that the staff have a shared understanding, and the children in the school have a shared understanding of the values that are important to the school and important to our authority.
Aside from being inclusive, it's just really helpful for young people. I'm really open and honest about who I am, so that they know that we're all in this together.